Hey guys, welcome back to Dwood. I'm David. Today I'm going to show you how I added an auto on feature for my exhaust fan on my Boss Laser. Okay, as many of you know, they have a Boss Laser. It comes with an automatic air assist on solenoid. It turns the air on when you start a job, or most of the machines do. However, for some reason, Boss did not include an automatic exhaust fan relay, which would turn your exhaust fan on as soon as you start a job and stop it when you end that job. In this video, I'm going to show you how I installed one with a timer that delayed that exhaust fan shutting off for 10 seconds. I am by no means an electronics expert, a Boss Laser expert, or any kind of wiring or electrician in any way. The things I show you is simply what I did, and I take no responsibility for anything you may do or your abilities and how you do it. Do this at your own risk. Let's get started. As you can see, I've gone ahead and pulled my machine out away from the wall so I can access the back panel. I'm going to go ahead and start a job. Start, and then I'm just going to pause it. So that way it has triggered the air to be on, and I can find out which circuit that is to then tap into. Okay, as you can see, we're here at the back of the machine. I have the AWC-708C Trojan controller here at the back. With the machine on, it started the job and I've got it paused. The air solenoid is on and powered, which is this pink wire right here. So what we're gonna do to make sure that that's the case is we are going to take our ground. I'm going to put it on the ground right here at the motor. I'm going to test the connection here at the pink terminal, and you can see the lights come on. So that shows that we have 24 volts at that point. Now I'm going to turn the machine off or stop the job, and we'll check it again. Okay, the machine is still on, but I've stopped the job. We're gonna ground out and check that spot again, and there is no power. Okay, now that the machine is shut off and unplugged, what I'm gonna do is undo this terminal and splice in a blue wire, and this will be my trip wire that will go to the timer delay, and then from the timer delay out to the power strip. First thing I'm gonna do is take this cover off, which you just pop it off like that. Okay, the wire I'm using is a solid wire. It is not braided, so it will go up in there very easily to make contact. I'll leave a link down in the description below to what I'm using. Okay, here is my timer board. This is the XY-LJ-02. There's a good video that I'll link down in the description on how to function this this circuit board. I'm gonna show you how I wired mine up for my application, and it should work with yours. The way I'm gonna power this is with a micro USB. It'll plug into the top here, and that will power the board. Okay guys, let's stop right there. While doing that part of the video, I realized that I was not going to use the micro USB and that I was going to actually use power straight from the controller, which I'll show you in the diagram right here, and we'll go over how I actually wired this up, and this will be available for you to download. Okay guys, I've got a diagram here that I drew up. Hopefully it makes sense. I'm gonna try to walk you through it, make it a little easier than just looking at a picture and trying to figure it out. Here's your controller that's at the back of the machine that I was showing you. Here's the blue wire coming out of it, which would be the this area right here, one period out one, and that should be only having power when a job is running, which is what triggers the air the air controller. So the blue wire, which is that power only when a job is running, comes out and goes up to the high input side of your timer. Okay. Now you've shown that you've also got a ground, which I grounded to the 3-period laser 4, which is right here. And any ground will work. They all go to the same place. But if you follow the ground up, it connects into this first connection here, then also connects in to the second down connection, and then goes out to the power supply. Next, we have our constant power. This is what we're going to use instead of the micro USB to power this timer. It comes out and it is a constant power 1 out 3, which is in the same area. Number 3, out 3 on here. So it comes out and goes in to this second from the bottom positive connection here. Then I also connect a wire coming back out of there and looping around to the other side. Now, I did not put a switch in this video. This diagram here is to kind of show you how to put a switch in if you want to switch it, just be able to switch it on manually. I may do another video later if I add that in to show you how I did that. But if you just follow this wire, it'll come and cut this part out straight over. And this is where it would connect back in to the center on this side. This is supplying power to the relay. Then when the trigger wire is tripped, this relay will connect these two, which will send power out to the power supply. What the switch does is bypasses this relay. You have the power coming in, and then when you turn it on, the power comes out and connects back into the wire going straight to the power supply. Like I said, this wire here, I do not have on mine and I'm not showing you in this video. Basically, you can imagine this power wire coming straight across and connecting back here. Okay? The other part I wanted to show you is the setting that you want to use is P7. This is on P1 is what it's showing in this picture. It's P7. I'll link in the video description below a video that's very good at showing you how to operate the settings in this setup. OP means output. That means it's been triggered. The relay is on. It is supplying power out. So that will be flashing, as you'll see in the video. That means it's got a trigger wire, has power to it. Then you have your timer here. I had mine set to 10 seconds. I've actually been using it a little while now, and I'm going to up that probably to 15 to 20 seconds. I hope this diagram helped, and I will set this so you can download it and be able to look at this a little closer yourself. Now back to the video. I have mounted this board with the standoffs that it came with. I just super glued them to a piece of wood. And then I hot glued that to the controller. So that's on there good and tight. Okay, I had to go a little bit of a different route with this. Instead of using the micro USB connector to power it, I ended up finding power on number 3 right here. You use your voltmeter to find power wherever you need it. It doesn't need much power. I ran power from there to this terminal. And then there's a ground that's being shared amongst all the grounds needed. The trip wire is going from number 1 up here to the high side, which is high voltage in, up to I think it's 24 volts. Then the jumper wire for the power is jumping from our constant power on this terminal here around to our middle terminal here, which is our input. And then our output is going right here. Okay, as you can see on the meter, we have no power coming out of the output, but on the input, we have 24 volts. I'm gonna go and start a job and pause it and show you that that power then will be coming out of the output. Okay, that job has started and has supplied signal to this side of the board, which now has your output
supplying power, as shown by touching the bottom terminal here, and we have 24 volts. This will go up to the power supply, supplying it with the power, turning the relay on for the fan. Now, let's see if I can get back here fast enough after shutting the power or the job off, hitting stop, and show you that it delays for 10 seconds. As you can see, it's counting down. We have power. And the relay shuts off and we no longer have power, which will shut the fan off. Now all we've got to do is tidy these wires up, zip tie them up. I'm going to run the wires up to the power supply and I'll show you how to wire that.
Okay, back up at the top of the machine. This is the power supply. There'll be a link in the description below where to get this. You simply run your two wires coming out of the controller down there into your positive and negative here. This simply pulls out to attach your wires to, and then you push it back in. You have your normally off, which is what we want to use, normally on, and always on. So what we're going to do is we're in the normally off, turn the power supply on. This is my fan controller here. I'll start a job. Starts the fan. Now I'm going to end the job and it'll be a 10 second countdown where it'll shut that fan off. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope that this helped you with setting up your automatic exhaust fan setup. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Leave a comment below if you got yours to work with this and how it turned out. If you would, it would greatly help me if you would like and subscribe to my channel. There'll be more videos based on the Boss Laser coming out, along with woodworking and other videos. Thanks for watching.